Hey, shalom, brothers and sisters. I want to share with you something that's been on my heart lately. And I believe this to be two principles for walking in the Spirit and for knowing God's will and living a life that's pleasing to God. These two principles come from one verse, from John chapter 6 and verse 15, where it's written that people wanted to take Jesus by force and make him king. But what did he do? It says that he went away and he went on the mountain to be by himself with God, to be alone with God. And the two principles that we can take out of this passage is, first of all, humility, and second of all, being alone with God, spending time in his presence, in the secret closet where nobody sees us. First, the humility. We see that Lord Jesus Christ himself, being God, that he humbled himself to the point of taking on human flesh and to the point of dying for our sins on the cross. He didn't receive glory of man, he didn't receive honor of man, but he was seeking only to please his Father in heaven and to do his will. And at that moment, when people wanted to glorify him, as it were, and lift him up to make him king, he departed. He fled away from those flattering words. And this is a big big thing, that if people are trying to praise you, what are you gonna do with it? Are you gonna give glory to God? You're gonna go away and be alone with God, as God, to keep you humble, not to make you boastful and prideful? Or are you gonna rejoice in the praises of men and seek to please them? If we are humble in the sight of the Lord, he will lift us up. And if we come near to God, he's gonna come near to us, it says in the book of James. And this is the second point that I'm trying to make, that the time spent alone, we see that Jesus Christ, he went on the mountain to be alone with God by himself. We need that, brothers and sisters, so much. We need this being alone with God, that we just go on our knees somewhere where we have peace, when nobody disturbs us, no distractions, and we just seek his face and wait upon him on our knees until he shows up in his glory, that God starts to speak to our hearts, and even more, that he starts to share his heart with us, his pain for this fallen world, his pain for the church that's being lukewarm so long. Brothers and sisters, when God starts to share his heart with you, if you are open to it, if you are seeking for him, if you start to get to know his heart by studying his word, if you see his character through his attributes that are so beautifully shown to us through his word, and if you personally know Jesus Christ, not only by head knowledge, but by knowing him through prayer, through secret time in secret place, then God is gonna start to pour out his heart in you. He's gonna work that love in you for the lost world and for the church. And then you can walk through a shopping mall and barely holding back your tears, because you see how fallen humanity is. And once we have that compassion for the lost, when we go out and preach the word of God, that compassion comes out naturally. It's just like Jesus said, it's like the water of life that's just flowing out of us. It has to come naturally. You cannot fake it. You cannot fake that spirit-filled life. And you have to build it up in the secret closet, and by keeping yourself humble and fleeing away from praises of men, and stop pleasing men but please God. And brothers and sisters, if we as church start to see God more when nobody is looking at us, when when we are alone in this, in the secret closet, in prayer, in deep prayer to God. Someone once said, pray until you pray. We have to break through in prayer. It is not just speaking a few words to God. It is seeking His will and waiting on the Holy Spirit to pray through us, to bring to remembrance things to pray for. And when we bring, when we pray according to His will, now we know that we receive what we ask for. Oh dear brother, there is so it's life in abundance, what Jesus spoke about, in the presence of God, life in abundance. And the world just becomes so unattractive if we see God for who He really is, if we meet Him so close. And I just pray that that may be true in the lives of all of us, of every Christian, every born again believer. The door is open. The way is open to the throne of grace, and we can come there by boldness through the blood of Jesus Christ. Do we come with boldness to God? It says in Acts chapter 4 verse 13 that when they saw the boldness the disciples had, they knew they were with Jesus. My brothers and my sisters, that boldness is a Greek word, paresia, and it means to have overflowing words. It's the Holy Spirit giving you words at the right time, at the right moment, to speak according to His will and His word. And people will notice. They will notice if you spending time with God. People will notice. It will make an impact on your neighborhood, on your city. It's going to have an impact wherever you are. You will shine the light of Jesus Christ. I pray that this blesses you and that this helps you and that it encourages you to seek the Lord, to seek Him, because He wants to be found. God bless you. Shalom.